happen? I thought, like, this weather's crazy.
It is ridiculous. We get incredible winds yesterday, and we talked about this last week. Which model do you believe? And we had a model last week that said, hey, we got another little piece that's coming behind the main storm yesterday. And that's what we're getting. So lately, the little guys have been doing more for us than the big guys have. Big storm rolling through Denver yesterday gave some areas of the Front Range more than a foot of snow. Well, we're not seeing that. But what we are seeing is some showers breaking out here in the metro area. And I'll show you the storm and what it's going to do here in just a moment. But across central Bernalillo County and out into the East Mountains, we're changing over to some snow as well as you slide up out to the east. Scattered showers along the I-40 corridor and then steady snow in some areas of the northern mountains, especially those east slopes doing pretty well right now for picking up snow at this point. We're starting to see more snow work its way toward the Taos area and up into the Ski Valley and Red River too. Now, as far as what we've got going here, winter weather advisories in place from Chama across the northern mountains through all of Colfax County and across the northeast to include the I-25 corridor through tonight and into tomorrow as well. Winter storm warnings north of Durango and Pagosa Springs. I'll get through snow amounts here in just a minute. Freeze warnings tomorrow morning for the northeast, out into east central sections and up into the northwest plateau, where temperatures going to be just below freezing, it looks like. But those east winds have set up in a big way in the metro, and look how cold it is. It's 46 degrees. That's that cold air squeezing through the gaps in the canyon. You see that all the time here, and we're getting it at this point. That cold air is pooling to our east, so it's muscling its way through, and we're cooling nicely across the area. So look for gusty east winds throughout the night. Warm down to the south, temperatures in the 60s. Our little weather disturbance is right about here, dropping its way down toward the state and then going to curl its way on out during the day tomorrow. As it does, we'll continue with the chance of showers. So two different things really going on here. As the low slides its way on through, getting some of that cold air that's punching its way through. So a lot of what we're seeing in the mountains is snow. And obviously, we think the east slopes are going to do pretty well for snow. Places like Eagle Nest already have 4 inches of snow on the ground. Here into the metro, we could see gusts as high as 40 miles an hour from those east winds. Now, as far as precip goes, we're looking at a rain-snow mix. We could see some snow showers up into the foothills and rain elsewhere, or maybe rain-snow mixes elsewhere across the city here. We're not anticipating a great deal of precip, but one other thing to keep note of here, we're going to be fairly cool for tomorrow, and then check out these morning lows on Wednesday morning, close to freezing across many areas here. So we are going to have to watch that. We'll have more on that as we get a little closer. But here's a look at the storm targets and what we anticipate happening. East winds cranking up overnight in the metro, rain and snow showers through at least Tuesday morning, it looks like. Sharply colder with a valley freeze possible on Wednesday morning. Meanwhile, as you get out to the northeast, you guys under that winter weather advisory, any rain changes over to snow after midnight and AM snow to a mix on Tuesday. Again, we're not talking about huge snow accumulations here. So if you have travel plans, I wouldn't get that worried across the northeast unless you're in real high mountain locations. You're going to be okay, but it's just given the time of year, a little bit of an unusual storm. Northern mountains, snow expands tonight. East slopes favored. 6+ inches of snow will be possible above 8,000 feet. More on that in just a second. And cold through Wednesday. Meanwhile, up into the San Juans of southwestern Colorado, we're looking at 6 to 12 inches of snow. Scattered rain snow mixes down across the northwest plateau. And as far as those snow amounts go, there's a lot of areas that won't see much. Durango, Farmington, not worried about that. Durango Mountain Resort, Wolf Creek, both going to do well. Again, the elevated terrain is what we need to really pile up any snow. Chama doing okay, 4 to 6 inches. Los Alamos, fairly low snow numbers. And over the northern mountains, Eagle Nest, we've already got 4 inches of snow on the ground. We may add an additional 3 to 6, 4 to 6 in Red River, 5 to 10 in the Ski Valley. Angel Fire could see 3 to 6 as well. As you get out to the northeast, again, the lower terrain, an inch or two, a possibility here. So don't worry too much if you're headed out on the roads. And in the metro, we're not looking at any significant accumulation. Sandia and Manzano is about 1 to 4 inches. Santa Fe could grab an inch. Southern Colorado temperatures for the most part 50s for tomorrow. Morning showers possible, then afternoon clearing as you get out into the northwest. Spot morning mix and then clearing later on in the day. 56 Grants, 59 out in Farmington. Out to the southwest, mostly sunny skies here. North winds 10 to 15 miles an hour with temperatures in the 60s. Over to the southeast, some clouds and a spot shower possible later on tonight and throughout the day tomorrow with sharply colder temperatures. Northeast, scattered morning snow, and then you guys could grab a garden variety thunderstorm later on in the day tomorrow. Meanwhile, over the northern mountains, morning snow and really snow overnight tonight. Possibility of melting some of that off with a scattered mix during the day tomorrow. 40s for the most part in the East Mountains. We're looking at snow above about 7,500 feet. And again, a few inches definitely possible. Metro area, some spot showers here. I don't think we're going to get a ton of precip out of this system, but we could get a little bit. And again, we're going to be cold enough that it could be looking at a few snow flurries around the area as well. And as we get into later on in the day tomorrow, then Wednesday, Thursday, things quiet down. Temperatures rebound significantly as well. We'll have updates on Twitter throughout the night at KRQE Mark.
All right, good stuff. Mark, thank you.